Now, you had brought up Ian Freeman. I think that's his name. I'm not sure if that's his last name or not. It's immaterial. Of the Free State Project conflict. From what I understand, besides the whole pedophile thing, the feds weren't actually targeting him because of his comments. From what I've gathered, the more subtle issue is that he had been evading taxes for 5 years. I think it was 5 years. Any thoughts?
Sure. I wrote about this in my last article called Disingenuous Activists. And I, for the first time, I actually defended Ian Bernard because I think he's being unjustly profiled for, look, in this country, there is a presumption of innocence until proven guilty, not the other way around. So it doesn't matter what he's being accused of until he's had something resembling his day in court. The fact of the matter is that he's been accused of a whole bunch of things. It could also be that he's innocent, but like I said, there is such a thing as a presumption of innocence. And what the Free State Project did for a man who is presumed to be innocent is rather unconscionable. They kicked him out specifically because of what he's being accused of. Now, with allies like that, who needs enemies? And, that's kind of what's being faced here. So if Ian Bernard, who is the FSP's most successful recruiter, no disagreement about that from anybody's camp that I can tell. If he was the most successful recruiter, somebody who should be in a rather safe position, if his position wasn't safe, then whose is in any of these so-called activist organizations, to be perfectly honest?
Indeed. Dan, go ahead.
So I've been kind of monitoring this closely. I've actually interacted with him a little bit. What he said, while it's incendiary and inflammatory, is it not within the right of, I don't want to say right, I can't think of a better term, the right of the FSP to sit there and say we no longer choose to associate with someone who has stated something so controversial? Like, the FSP is a private enterprise. Now, what they've done is explicitly and publicly, kind of shamed him. But I kind of expect that. I don't want to say.
Without going on too much longer about this, because we're supposed to be discussing guerrilla warfare. The only thing that I will add on to it is this: I wrote 3 years ago an article entitled "The Free State Project Censorship Debacle" on November 3rd of 2013, which was about a month or so after George Donnelly wrote his article basically defending the Free State Project. Here's the main problem, and here's where George Donnelly and some other people defending the Free State Project, Board of Trustees, not the rank and file, but the Board of Trustees really kind of didn't really understand what was happening, or they wanted to gloss over it because they wanted to mitigate some sort of PR disaster. The fact of the matter is that regarding Chris Cantwell's ostracism, the board, which met behind closed doors, is the only relevant source of authority within the FSP, not its membership. The membership are just hangers-on at best, so they're completely disrespected, and they're totally not represented. The board refuses to discuss matters publicly with their membership, as their minds are already made up. The board provides no means for an individual to argue his case before them, as was the case with Cantwell and Bernard both. The board is arbitrary and capricious in their decisions. The board appears to be comfortable with censorship, so much for your free speech. The board makes their own rules in secrecy, given that they are not made available to the membership of the FSP. And at the time, if you remember, Danny, Judy Underwood, one of the trustees, was basically saying that we have policies and we want to enforce these policies, but you can't see the policies. There's absolutely no transparency. Last two things I'll say very briefly. The board is not representative. They have no provision for input from members of the FSP, although they act as if they have implied police powers, like they're a government unto themselves, a despotic government especially. And finally, the board fails to recognize the Constitution of New Hampshire, as was just read a little bit ago regarding the right of revolution. So they're in the wrong as far as I'm seeing. And oh, by the way, only individuals have rights. The Free State Project Board of Trustees has no rights. Similarly, government has no rights. Only individuals have rights. So this little tiny oligarchical wannabe group called the FSB Board of Trustees throwing out Chris Cantwell for his free speech, mentioning, reminding people about the right of revolution, or late 3 years later, which is more recent months, throwing out Ian Bernard is just they're despotic. They're despotic. They are exactly the type of activist organization that I've warned people in my last article to not join. Because, and by the way, this is under relatively peaceful conditions. If we were actually in a situation, a hot war, whether guerrilla or otherwise, can you imagine if there was a shooting war, how the FSP or people like that would treat their rank and file, their membership, under harsher conditions? That's kind of rather disconcerting. Also notice how people treated on all sides. Look how everybody treated those folks up in Harney County, Oregon. Whether you agreed with them or not, the fact is that there is such a thing as free speech. There is such a thing as presumption of innocence until proven guilty. And there is such a thing that the government likes to do, which is chilling dissent. And unfortunately, the Free State Project Board of Trustees was assisting the government in chilling the dissent of their own membership. And that is a fact. That is history. And God help us if Americans found themselves in the middle of a guerrilla war or a hot situation where the government was shooting at people, because the question is who's going to be the first batch of Volksdeutschers, as was the case in Nazi-occupied Poland, where you had Polish folks collaborate with the Nazis to sell out their own people. That is a very serious matter. And so it's not completely crazy to say that maybe something like that could happen if the situation here in America deteriorated like that, where it is a shooting war, and there would be just people lining up. They can call themselves patriots, they can call themselves libertarians, but if push comes to shove, they're going to buckle down and snitch, quite frankly. And all I'm saying is, while things are relatively peaceful now, relatively, because there is the issue of democide that's by certain government agents here and there, you do have to keep in mind that, quite frankly, if under these relatively easy conditions, the FSP Board of Trustees and similar organizations are going to sell out their own people and ostracize them for nothing, then what wouldn't they do when things get much, much worse? That's all I'm saying.